What's up, guys? It's your boy H.E. and I've got another great unboxing for you tonight. And this one's a little different, kind of a little bit old and new, but hopefully in this box we have a monitor. And let me just prelude this unboxing by talking about why I have a monitor in this box when I already have a monitor. You guys know that I just recently finished building my Hackintosh machine, and I have a monitor for that, one that I was actually going to be selling about 2 months ago, which is my Flattron IPS 235 version model monitor from LG. I was going to be getting rid of this LED monitor, and I had a change of heart and said, well, I'll just keep it around and hopefully I'll find some use for it. And lo and behold, I purchased the PlayStation monitor at that time, that 24-inch PlayStation branded monitor. I was having some issues with it, and I decided that that just wasn't for me, and I actually went back to my Flattron monitor for my Photoshop work and for gaming, and now for my Hackintosh, which has been working out really well for me. It's got a bunch of different input swaps on it, or not a bunch, but you've got DVI, you've got HDMI, and I think you've got one other. So to make a long story short, while I'm dragging on here, I've been looking for another one of these monitors, another one of those monitors, and I didn't want to spend a lot of money. So I found this guy on eBay that had a refurbished one, a factory refurbished one, hopefully, and the price was great. The monitor runs anywhere from $240 all the way upwards of $399, and I was able to get this one for just a little over $100 refurbished, which is great if it works. So what I'm going to do is unbox it for you tonight, hopefully set it up, and we'll kind of take a look at it and just kind of see where we go from here. So without me talking a whole lot more, let's get to unboxing. I don't know, I'm always scared when I see brown boxes versus the actual box, but you know, you do have to ship it, especially when it's something refurbished. I get a little nervous, but it looks like there's an LG IPS 235 version box inside. And what do you know? Let me pick it up for you. And so you can see, there it is, and there it is. And so far, from what I can see initially, it looks a lot like my other box, which is great. First thing here is that we've got the box, which I've shown you before, and this looks like the exact monitor, which I'm stoked about, if in fact it works. The box looks in great condition, so let's open it up and go into it and see where we end up. I got to be real careful cutting here because I'm always scared. I don't know how they packed it. This damn screen could be facing forwards or something, which would be a huge epic fail on my part. So yeah, by the way guys, I've got a lot of great Hackintosh videos coming up. I am going to do a video where I discuss why I have optical drives at this stage and why I actually need them for what I do every day. And I'm going to do a lot of benchmarking videos for my Hackintosh. That stuff is coming. And keep subscribing. Before we go into this, I just want to talk about my subscription situation. We're at somewhere very close to 7,000 subscribers, which is really great for my channel. Everybody that has subscribed and believes in me, thank you. I'm going to do my damnedest not to disappoint you and to keep bringing you great content. But on the flip side, as I told you before, if we can hit that 10,000 subscriber mark, that's where we need to go. If we can hit that mark, I will come from behind the camera and actually start to do a lot of these reviews and stuff in front of the camera, which I hope will give you guys a better idea of who I am and what I'm about, and you can get to see my face so you can kind of relate a little bit better. We just got to get to that 10,000 subscriber mark, so I need your help to that was kind of cheesy. Take three. I need your help to help me get there, and hopefully we can do it by the end of this year. I'm confident. It's just January, the end of January, but I think we can make it because I've got the best group of subscribers on YouTube, bar none. Back to what we came for. Got a box here. We've got the registration card. Woo-hoo! We've got what looks to be the manual check. We've even got a disc, which I'm not going to need for my purposes. We're going to remove this. And we've got the actual screen. Screen looks to be in fabulous shape. No scratches whatsoever. You can tell they wiped it down. And it looks just like my other monitor, as you will see very soon. It says Flatron IPS 235 version there. Of course, it's an LG monitor. Got all the buttons here, power and other buttons. And the actual buttons are on the bottom there, as you can see. Very easy to access. And if you look on back, it has here DVI, VGA, I believe. No, excuse me, D-Sub, VGI, headphone, and HDMI. And I generally will use DVI and HDMI. Because what I also plan to do with this is I'm going to buy probably the device from Matrox or somebody, the dual head to go. And what I want to do, as well as using two monitors for my Hackintosh, I want to use two monitors running out of my PlayStation 3 so that I can have one gigantic, or at least one very long screen, two 23-inch monitors to power my Black Ops 2 and other games. And I'll show you guys how that works out too. I get enough thumbs up on this video, I will go ahead and order that part and install it and kind of show you guys what I think about it. There's more. Got the power cord here. Check. They did give me, this is the funniest thing. But I guess, I mean, they said D-Sub, but this is really a VGA. Gave me a VGA adapter, which I won't use. But I'm glad they at least included a plug and the stand, which is exactly like my other stand. So the next thing that we're going to do is install this guy. Let me show you guys really quickly what my workstation looks like right now. And don't worry about the mess, because it is just a little messy. Stand by for the earthquake. This is what my workstation looks like right now. I've got my HD camera here, my Logitech, which I absolutely love. Got stereo microphones. Here's my IPS that's already up. Bunch of other crap. So there's gonna be one here in a few seconds. So stand by while I hook everything up. I will be doing an updated room tour once I rearrange everything, because I am gonna go with a custom built glass desk pretty soon. Talk about that more in another video. But yeah. Here's one monitor, here's two monitors. Hopefully we'll have both of them together and working real soon. All right guys, so check it out. I finally got both monitors hooked up and I'm running it maybe a little different than what you would normally see. If you look on this side, this is my actual quarterback. And this is my running back, if you want to use football analogies. But this is the quarterback position. This is where everything will be run from. As you can see, my dock and all that good stuff across the top. My toolbar and all my hard drives. So, and the reason I did this is because I'm going to use this particular monitor on the left to play my game. And do both two-screen editing and other stuff. And I want to be able to still search the web and still be able to monitor my Elgato game capture video card from this screen. So that's why I ran it this way, and this just seems most efficient for me. I have not buttoned up the wires yet because I was still testing to make sure that everything works. And so far, so good. I'm really impressed with, you know, the way the setup hopefully is going to end up. One thing I wanted to show you guys is this little program I have called Shades, and definitely go and pick it up. It's a free download. You can just Google search it and it downloads to your system preference pane. But if you go into it, it'll take a second to load, and let me push in so I can show you what I'm talking about. Great program for goofing off and being able to adjust the brightness and calibrate monitors that are non-Apple. So I really like it. And if you look here, I've got both of these monitors registering. One is running, the one on the right is running through HDMI, the one on the left is running through DVI, because I only have one HDMI on my graphic card, which is the Asus 680 card. But what was I going to show you? Lost my thought for a second. Let's go up here and talk for a second. If you see those two brightness icons, one is for each monitor, and they work really well. You click on it, and you can adjust brightness, and I can do it for either monitor. So what that means, and let's go back out, Mr. Science, is I can say on this left monitor, I can drop that monitor all the way down on this one, I can drop it all the way down too. And I can do it independently, which I really like. And I like to keep them somewhere around 80%. And I can come back up and adjust this. Maybe I want this one a little lower. It just depends on my mood. I can adjust this. And this is a great tool if you're working with a non-Apple monitor. Jesus Christ, somebody is killing me. My poor iPad's about to explode. Who is this? Oh, I had like 3 different messages. That's it, guys. That is my review of my unboxing, rather, of my newest LG IPS 235 version monitor. And it's an LED monitor. It has decent response times, anywhere from 8 to 14 milliseconds, which aren't great, but are pretty good. I'm very happy with what I have here, with this setup. It looks really good. Colors are pretty crisp for me. The blacks could be a little blacker, but they are good. I have no problem doing my Photoshop editing or After Effects or Final Cut Pro 10 or anything else that I want to do, or surfing the web or watching videos. And just for you guys, I've got a few of my videos actually here, and I'm gonna drag one across, and I'm gonna go full screen here, and I'm gonna go full screen here. And I'm gonna play this one, and let's see if I can get rid of the audio. I wonder, can I go full screen on both of these at the same time? Well, hell yes, I can. And we've got some conflicting audio here, but you know, you guys get the message. Both of them are running at the same time. On the right is my original IPS unboxing that you can find on my page. And to the left here is just one of my newest videos of this Apple TV that I unboxed. Thank you guys so much for the support, and thank you guys so much for hanging in here with me. This was a little fun project to kind of finish off my Hackintosh for now. The only thing that we are still missing is the Blu-ray burner/reader that'll be coming up soon. And I'm really thinking about adding another one of those 680 graphics cards from Asus. I may or may not. Outside of that, the Hackintosh project is pretty much complete. I'll be giving you more videos soon. Thanks for the support as always. Hit that like button and show me some love. See you next time.